Hi, I'm Olivia from the Alias Directory team here at Visa. Today, I'll guide you through the use of the Alias Resolution and Alias Inquiry APIs within the Alias Directory service. So once Stacey is enrolled on the platform, she can start receiving and sending funds using her alias, such as an email or phone number. Let's consider a scenario where Stacey wants to repay her dad, Gary, for a lunch they shared earlier today. Firstly, Stacey logs onto her banking application and selects the option to make a payment. Stacey then fills in the details for the transaction. She first selects if it's a domestic or international transaction. As her dad is also in the US, Stacey clicks the domestic payment. She then selects the account where she wants to pull the funds from and enters the amount that she owes her dad for the lunch. She then clicks Next. At this point, Stacey's bank initiates a call to the Alias Inquiry API. This API checks Stacey's contact list to identify who is registered within the Alias Directory service. The Inquiry API returns a list of contacts who were registered on the Alias Directory, indicated by the ADS logo you can see here. Importantly, no personally identifiable information is returned, just a simple indication that the alias is registered in the directory. Stacey sees that her dad's name is marked with an alias logo, indicating that he is also registered in the alias directory and means she doesn't need to manually enter his card details. Stacey therefore selects her dad's name to initiate the payment. At this point, Stacey's bank calls the Alias Resolution API. This API uses Gary's alias, in this case his phone number, and returns the payment credential associated with his profile to Stacey's bank. In this case, the Alias Resolution API returns Gary's debit card information, as this is his preferred payment method for receiving funds. The Alias Resolution API also returns Gary's partial name. This acts as a confirmation step, as Stacey will be asked to verify the details to ensure accuracy. As Stacey's bank now has Gary's payment credential information, Stacey can click Send to execute the payment. It's important to note that while the Resolution API returns Gary's payment credentials to Stacey's bank, this information will never be visible to Stacey herself for security reasons. Stacey will then be presented with the transaction confirmation screen so she can inform her dad, Gary, that the payment has been made successfully, all enabled by Visa.